the shadow to my light. Did you feel us?
Hey YouTube family, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If it's your first time joining, this is Katanjali from Queens, New York. Here I am doing another post-quarantine vlog on my trip to Portland, Maine. So this is day two in Portland, Maine. And today is July 21st, 2020. And I'm just like hanging out in my hotel room until my Uber gets here. So I thought I would just give a day two itinerary before I head out. If you can see in the background, that's the view of the city. Portland, Maine. I'm actually staying in Old Port, Portland, Maine, and I'm just gonna get my notepad here. So day two, I have a lot going on. I decided to do some lighthouse hopping. For those who know the history around Portland, Maine, Portland is known for their lighthouses, and they have about 65 lighthouses throughout Portland. So yeah, so I'll focus on the five lighthouses. And then after that, I'm planning on going. I wanted to do a brewery tour. So Portland is known for their breweries, but because of COVID-19, some of the breweries are not open for tours. But based on my research online, Rising Tide Brewery, their patio is open. So I'm gonna check that out. I really wanted to go to the Allagash Brewery, but that's okay. It's always another time. And then after that, I'm actually planning on going to this donut place. It's called Holy Donuts, and apparently they make donuts. Their donuts are made out of potato, so I'm looking forward to that. In addition, I'm gonna spend the remaining of the day at Peaks Island, and it's a 15-minute ferry ride from Old Port. So yeah, I'm really excited about that. All right, come along, enjoy. Greetings from Cape Elizabeth. Cape Elizabeth is about a 14-minute drive from Old Port, Portland, Maine. Here is where Maine's oldest lighthouse is located. That's right. Can you guess what's the name of the lighthouse? Yes, it's actually called Porthead Lighthouse, and it's also considered one of the most photographed lighthouses in America. Also find a museum here. There are a lot of food trucks outside, and it's just a beautiful area to just relax and enjoy the scenery. So get ready for this lighthouse. It's right behind me. Isn't it absolutely gorgeous? All right, so come along and enjoy.
Shadow to my light, did you feel us? Another star, you fade away. Afraid our aim is out of sight. Wanna see us alive.
I'm actually in the Lighthouse Museum, and it's $2 to get in. I just found out that this lighthouse first keeper was George Washington. Wow, that's pretty amazing. It's a really small museum, and because of COVID-19, they're just allowing, I think, 3 people at a time. So there are 2 other people in here with me. It's stunning. I feel like you can only invest maybe 10 minutes or so. It's really tiny. But it's cute to see the layout and the history. Hey guys, so I found this food truck in Elizabeth Cape. And it's literally, I would say, like a 3-minute walk from the lighthouse. And it's called Bite in Maine. And I read really good reviews about them on Yelp. So here's the lobster roll. And it's so like hot out here, so I got a root beer, Maine root beer. Let's see how it tastes. It's actually organic. Ooh.
So needed this. They have lemon on the side. Lobster sugar. Look how chunky it is. Oh, actually, this lobster roll came with some curry on it. Curry mayo. Oh my god. Lobster with curry mayo. And you can taste the curry on it. I don't know if you can see it. Try to get this up really close. So the yellowish thing is the curry. And you could actually smell the curry, like the curry powder. Mmm. So
Bug Lighthouse, and it's so beautiful here. It's right behind me. Look at that pathway to get there. Cobblestone. It's obviously on the water. Beautiful. Based on my research, the architect of this lighthouse was Thomas Wader, and he was actually architect for our U.S. Congress building. So yeah, just a little history about it. I feel like this lighthouse, so you can get a little close and personal. So yeah, come along with me. So good. Oh. I think it's better than my AC at home. Oh, this is amazing. It would be nice to retire here at some point. Not here, but retire where the lake is. Or, you know, the beach. That's many, many years from now. It's not open. I think it's open only on the weekends. It's sort of like an industrial area on the other side, and they're open on the weekends from noon to 5. So I'm guessing they're opening for the workers. I can stand here forever. I wish you guys could smell the smell and take in the fresh air with me. Like I'm walking on glacier rocks or something. Even dangerously.
Light, did you feed us? Another star, you fade away. Afraid our aim is out of sight. Wanna see you.
ferry. I'm heading to Peaks Island. So this ferry kind of reminds me of the Amsterdam ferry. It takes vehicles as well as people over to Peaks Island. So yeah, come along and enjoy this adventure with me.
I love.
All right. Like a ton of breweries. They're actually all, most of them are next to each other, and I decided to visit Rising Tide. So I was able to get a flight, and so they're known for their blueberry Daymark Maita. So what is Maita? It's the Maine Island Trail Ale, and it's basically IPA, and they're also known for their Weather the Storm. So I decided to get a sample of each, just to see how it tastes like. So here I am. This is the blueberry. Smells like blueberry. Oh, by the way, Maine, so they're known for their blueberries, right? So hence. All right, here I go. It's actually a little, it tastes like soda, sort of. It has like that aesthetic taste to it, but overall it's neutral. I feel like it will be a perfect summer drink. So here, let me take another taste. Pretty good. And the next one is Maita. So remember, Maita is Maine Island Trail Ale. Apparently it's 4.3% bright body with bold notes of citrus and pine, brewed in support of Maita.org. This is how it looks like. Oh, I could definitely taste the IPA. The IPA is definitely kicking in. Thank you so much. I'm definitely used to this, especially coming from New York City. I think so far, my favorite is the blueberry. All right, next one is the Daymark. So Daymark is an American pale ale. We can usually get this in New York City. It's locally grown rye beer with bright floral aroma. All right. This is how it looks like. I need to take another sip. Definitely American pale ale. And the last one is Weather the Storm. And it's dry hop. It's actually crispy dry hop with calypso and cashmere, with hints of orchard fruit, clean malt, and earthy bitterness. Actually, definitely tastes. Smells a little different. It is definitely dry. It's alright. Not my favorite so far. And then for a small bite, I decided to get the elote Mexican street corn. Wanted to try something different, so it's cotija cheese, spicy mayo, cilantro, and if you want to add like meat, it's an extra $3. So I'm just gonna like, I just got it without meat. This is how it looks like. Smells really good. I feel like it's gonna get messy. So you can see that the cilantro is all over. It's actually a serve with 3 pieces of corn. The cilantro is all over. It has a little bit of, I think that's purple onion. The mayo is all over it. Wow, it smells really good. All right, here I go, trying it. Juicy. You could actually taste the spiciness. Shallow waters never met what I needed. I'm letting go a deeper dive. Eternal silence of the sea. I'm breathing alive. Where are you now? Where are you now? Under the bright face. I really hope you enjoyed my vlog today. It was such an amazing day in Portland, Maine. I was able, just to give a recap, so today I was able to actually, sorry, I'm looking at my notes. I was able to go to the Rising Tide Brewery, and in case you're in Portland, Maine, and you're staying in Old Port, Portland, Maine, they have like a ton of breweries that's on this one block. I feel like these breweries are not popular, but it's a really good way to actually go to the breweries and get to know the locals in Portland, Maine. Met so many amazing people here today. Just wow. The Portland, Maine does definitely have a lot of friendly folks here. I really enjoyed that experience. I was able to see 4 lighthouses. I was able to see Portland Headlight in Cape Elizabeth, and also I tried some food from one of the food truck, so that was really fun. I wasn't able to see Ram Island Ledge Lighthouse. Apparently that island, folks are not able to go at the moment to see that lighthouse, but I was able to see it from a distance. I guess I didn't do enough research, so that's something to keep in mind. I also went to Bug Light House, and it was amazing. It's so beautiful. I felt like I had the whole lighthouse for myself. And from Bug Light House, you could actually walk to Spring Point Head Lighthouse. It's about like a 26-minute walk. I actually took the ferry from Casco Bay Island. So that's also in Portland, Old Port, Portland, Maine. And the ferry ride was about a 15-minute ride. It's $7.50 one way. Fortunately, I think it's because of COVID-19, the restaurants are not open. But it's a really cute island. You may want to scope that out. I heard that the restaurants and the bars and the cafes are usually open on the weekends, but it was a good experience, and it's just really nice to be in the water, because especially if you're visiting during the summertime, it gets really hot, so that's a good way to cool off a little. So I was able to do that, and then I had dinner at a taco place around the block. I wasn't able to go to Holy Donuts, but I'm planning on doing that tomorrow. Stay tuned for day 3, my day 3 blog in Portland, Maine. And I really thank you for your time, and I hope this vlog was helpful, you know, just to get a better flavor of what Portland, Maine offers through my experience. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Want to see future vlogs, and thank you so much. Talk to you later. Bye.